Please welcome Jim Carter.
Thank you.
Welcome to Scandinavia.
Thank you very much. I apologise. I speak English, not Norwegian or Swedish. I'm so sorry. Please forgive me.
Maybe you could try.
Smek mina fräknar.
Smek mina fräknar.
Yeah,
okay. That's a good word.
Let's stick to English. we were talking about children's behaviour and bringing up children. And you seem so very, very well-mannered and very dignified. As a person, have you always been
well mannered? Yes, dignified. No, I was. I'm well mannered and dignified at this time of my life. I was. I've had many phases of my life, of course. You know, I've had the wild days and the rock and roll days. they are behind me.
And how did you look at the time?
I was a hippie because long hair. A big moustache. I looked like Frank Zappa. and it was very unpleasant, I have to say. Flared trousers, fur coat. Awful.
your character, Carson, as we saw him here, he's really all about good old-fashioned traditional manners, isn't he?
Completely. Very, very, very traditional, trying to hold back the tide of history. Very set in his ways, and it's crazy because the Downton Abbey is set at a time when society is changing, you know, and he's deeply resistant to that, very socially incredibly conservative.
What did you learn about that butler job? What did you learn something about it while working?
I mean, it was seen as a very good job. You weren't allowed to get married. The butler wasn't allowed to get married. The housekeeper wasn't allowed to get married. So Mrs. Hughes, the housekeeper, wasn't married, but she was called Mrs. Hughes.
You could have a fuck mate, kind of.
Just Tourette's.
I'm not Tom Jones, no. Heavens above.
You have to think of one thing.
Yes. You did it again?
Yes. It's incredible. I can see how he's got six children. He's got a one-track mind.
You've got a psychiatrist here today.
You are that too.
I've got to talk to you. I am a good enough parent, I have to say. I am a good enough parent.
And what did you learn about etiquette?
Well, there's some amazing. I mean, the world was run by rules, bizarre rules. Some of them quite clever. I mean, there's a lot of big formal dinner parties, and if people are visiting for dinner, then all the female guests would look at the lady of the house to see which way she turned. And if she turned this way to talk, then all the female guests would turn the same way to talk round the table for the first two courses, and then they were allowed to turn and talk to the person on their other side when the dessert came out.
Like what you do here.
Well, yeah, very like you do here, yes. So it meant nobody was left out. You weren't allowed to put your... Everybody puts their elbows on the table. Your kids put their feet on the table,
I would imagine.
But you couldn't put the... Because once you said grace, then it was the Lord's table and you weren't allowed to touch it.
Well, one thing I think about when I watch Downton Abbey, which I do, of course, it's on our channel. You almost never see the children.
There's very practical reasons for that. Yeah. They're very difficult to work with, and they cry all the time. Never work with children and animals. You know? At the opening, you see him walking to the house with the dog. We've had 14 dogs. 14
for
different
that one dog part.
Yeah. So occasionally there's a dog runs out of the room. That's probably dog number 13. we don't have the children very much, but that's for practical reasons.
Okay, but
really.
But maybe they didn't have the children as much.
The children were
with the dinner and
nanny. The children with the nannies, and they would be brought down to be shown to the parents for maybe an hour. A day, and in fact, the old lady, the dowager countess, the old lady, said, You know, but I saw my children. Someone said, you never had anything to do with your children. I saw them for an hour every day, and you know, and that was it.
Do you find it a bit tempting, though, to have this children brought
no,
to you?
No. I would like to have a butler, actually.
Well, yeah. Not me, mate. not me.
But that would be perfect.
Yes, fantastic.
Would you cope with a butler? Yeah.
But would you would like to have a butler, really?
Yeah.
But do you find it socially acceptable?
His voice. I'm no? so sensible for voice.
I'm not asking if you want...
Are you sure you know what butler means?
Baby. I can see it one time every day.
OK.
And then bring me everything.
I will.
And take care of my life.
I will attend to your every need.
Yeah. And would it be? I wonder. Would it be socially acceptable? I mean, in Sweden, in England,
people do. The super rich have butlers. Butlers are coming back, thanks to me. Thank you. No. I don't. Yeah. Oh, but butler schools in America. Because I mean, the success of Downton Abbey in America is. Indescribable.
But do they, like, in the old days, do they dress people in the morning? Is it like... Would you like to have someone dress you in the morning?
No.
Choose
like
your
that.
Clothes
but,
for
but
you?
I mean, maybe more like a personal assistant doing stuff that I don't have
That's
time with.
That's not the butler.
Yeah.
Well, but a full-time personal assistant, maybe. That.
But at home, you want to relax, don't you? You don't want to think, oh, Carson's boiled the eggs, I better get down for breakfast, you know.
No.
And they live the life by the gong, yeah. Get dressed for dinner, gong, going
but
out
that,
to dinner.
Then the butler has taken the power over the...
Yeah. The butler has a lot of power.
How did the series Downton Abbey change your career, change your life?
I'm sort of too old to worry about my career, really. I don't really worry about that. It's changed it in that I get recognised. I've been in Stockholm for about 6 hours. I cannot believe how many people have recognised photographs and autographs and thank you very much. It's very nice. Last winter, I went on a cycling holiday in Cambodia, and in the temples of Angkor Wat, in the jungles of Cambodia, on my bicycle, with Lycra, don't think about that, sweating, sort of passed a bunch of Chinese tourists, Mr. Carson!
But that must be quite awful, too. I mean, I think it's nice. I'm recognised in Sweden, but I think it's so nice to come abroad and nobody knows who I am, and I can sneak around and dance in the bushes and stuff. You know what I mean?
I do. Yeah. Don't forget, I used to be a hippie dancing in the bushes with my thing.
But now you have to. I mean, you have to watch for yourself all the time. What you do and so on.
Everywhere.
Yeah.
Which is very. It makes you very self-conscious.
They'll always be watching your manners. That's
yeah,
the thing.
Absolutely.
The manners are very.
You can go
you have
to North Korea.
Oh, good evening, my lady.
Jim, thank you so much for being here with
you.
Us tonight.
Thank you.
Harald Brun.